Hi, my name's Esther Allen, and I'm a medical laboratory technician here with the Department of Laboratory Medicine at North York General, and today I'm going to show you what happens to a blood sample. So we're in the emergency department where we've taken blood on a patient. Now it's sending it through the pneumatic tube system upstairs to the core laboratory, where there, in a speedy process, they'll receive the blood and do the appropriate testing that's been ordered for the patient. Laboratory where a specimen has just arrived through our pneumatic tube carrier system. We take the tube out over to the specimen processing desk where we open the carrier, remove the sample, and ensure that all the samples that are in the bag are all for the same patient. The tube then goes back into the carrier and we send back to the destination that it came from. At the specimen processing desk, we take the samples and receive them so that way we can do the appropriate testing. So once the samples have been received in the lab information system, if the sample is going to the biochemistry department, we take the sample and put it into a sample rack. This is where we load it onto our front-end automation, which takes the sample and loads it onto our analyzers. Once it's on the system, it takes it through a series of steps, including the centrifugation process, over to an aliquoting process, through to a barcode, and an archiving. Once the original sample is then archived, it takes an aliquot of the sample, which is just a portion of the original sample, and takes it to the sample analyzer where it's then tested. From there, any samples that have to go to other departments are walked over and put into the appropriate department rack. A technologist will pick it up from there and do the appropriate testing.